Hi, I'm George, and in this video I'll be showing you how to change background music inside of Minecraft. Now if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, don't forget to share, and of course subscribe to my channel. I do several videos every single week, about half of those on Minecraft. You can find out more about that on my channel. Okay, let's get to it. You change the background music inside of Minecraft by setting up a custom resource pack with your new music files in that custom resource pack. So we'll be doing one of those. You also need to know the proper names for those files because you can only use certain names. You can change the music, but you have to change the names of your music to match the names that are required for the Minecraft program. Let me bring up a list of that and I'll show you what we're talking about. Here we go. Now these are all of the music files inside of Minecraft, and if you want to change all of the music, you have to change all of these files. There's some here in this Sounds Music Game folder. There's a section down here in the Creative folder that's for the creative background music. There's music for the end, music for the nether, and also three things down here for water as well. Now to keep this simple, we'll just be changing these sounds right here. I'm working in creative mode right now, so we'll change the creative mode background music. Now the first thing we need to do is to set up a resource pack. Now if you already have one you're working on, you can put this or add this into your current resource pack. If not, you'll need to make a new resource pack, and that's where we'll start. So I have to get this game out of the way, and let's set up our resource pack. There we are. Now you need to have two drive windows open. There's one on my C drive, and here's another one over here. Now this is my destination location. I've made a folder in here from Minecraft, and since right now we're in version 1.151, I made a folder for that as well, and that's this location. I'll be building the resource pack in here. We now need to get the original resource pack, and you'll find that over here. If you type in, again this is just a drive window, if you type in the address bar up here, %appdata%, hit the enter key, that takes you into this location, which is the AppData roaming location. Now normally this is a hidden file location. This is one way to get to it. You can also get to this by going through the game, but this is pretty easy for this particular video. On this very top one up here where it says .minecraft, ignore that down there. That was a test folder I was running. But right here it says .minecraft. You want that one. Go into that. And in here, come way down here to where it says versions. Right there, open up that versions folder. Now this shows you all of the versions that you currently have on your computer. I have a whole bunch in here as you can see. I need to clean that out one of these days. Come right down and then find the most recent version. In this case it's this one here, 1.15.1. If you don't know what your current version is, when you open up your launch, when you first launch Minecraft, you'll be in the launch window, and at the bottom of that it will list the version number right down there. But right now it's 1.15.1. So go into that folder. And here you'll find two files, jar file and a JSON file. They both say version number right there. Now if you don't see the .jar and .json, go up here to view, and right over here where it says file name extensions, make sure that is checked, and you'll then see that extension. Now all you need to do is take the jar file, right drag that over into your drive window over here, other drive window. I've already done that, and that's sitting right there. There it is. Okay. That's all we need this for. We can close that one down. So here we go. We now have our jar file inside of our working folder on the hard drive. We need to extract the information out of this. Now you can use whatever program you want to for extracting it. Doesn't matter. It acts just like a regular zip file. So right click and then you can unzip this. I happen to use 7-zip. In that case, I'll do an extract 2. And there's the name of the new folder, and make sure it shows that name. If you're using another program like WinRAR, I have that one right down here. Same thing, extract to, and the name of the folder right there. So once that's been extracted, it's going to be as a folder. There it is. Let's go inside this one. And this is all of your information that's inside of that jar file. All we care about is the assets folder right here. Now I like to copy this out. So right click and then copy. Just like that. Go back one level, here we are, and then you do a right click and paste. I've already done that, and that puts the assets folder right here inside of this location. So that's all set to go. And here's where we'll be building our sound files, or putting our sound files in to change that background music. You're also going to need two more files. One is the pack.mc meta file. Let me open this one up and see what that is. That's all it is right here. Now you can download this from my website. There's a link for my download page in the description if you want to. If you're working in the current version 1.15, then this should be a 5 right there. If you're working in 1.14 or 1.13, this needs to be a 4. So just double check that. This is the download file on my website, so if you use that file, it's going to have 5 in there. Okay, I'll close that down. We have that. Next one here is the pack.png file. And this file is actually not required, but it's nice to have. It's just a PNG graphic image file, and as you can see right there, it's 256 by 256. I just have a picture of my spacesuit guy over there on the Mars background. So that's all that is. All this does is give you that image as an icon inside of your resource pack folder inside the game. If you don't have one of these, then you just get a default dirt image. I think it's in black and white in place of this, but I like having a custom picture, so you might as well go ahead and do that as well. Now I have a different picture in my download, just a picture of a panda that I drew a while ago. So that's what you get. Just change that picture to anything else that you want and then resave that PNG file. Okay, so you have those three pieces, the assets folder, the pack.mc meta file, and the pack.png icon file right there. Okay, now we need to set up that folder structure inside of our assets right here. So let's go in the assets, where it says Minecraft, go inside of Minecraft. In here, you're going to see these folders, block states, font, lang, which is language, models, particles, shaders. You won't see sounds, you will see texts, and you will see textures. We'll need to make a new folder here that says sounds. Let me bring up that list again so you can see what we're doing. There we go. So this is the folder structure that we're making right now, the Minecraft sounds, music, game, and creative. Let me just move this a little bit. I'll put that up like that. There we go. I can then put that right above this window over here. And there it is. Need to make this location. We're in the Minecraft folder right now. So you need to make the sounds folder. Inside of that, you need to make a music folder. That's that bit right there. Inside of that, you need a game folder. Open that one up, and inside of that we're doing a creative folder because we're changing the music in creative mode. Let's just go inside of that one, and in here is where you're going to be putting in your sound files. Let's go back and take a look at this again. So that is for changing the music in creative. If you want to change the music in the end, you'd change this folder or set up this folder structure. Notice that this is still in the game folder. We're just changing or adding in a new folder here for end, a new folder for nether, and a new folder for water right down there for all of those. And then in just that game folder, without a separate folder or additional folder, we have all of these. These are your standard sound files, standard music files in here for your background music in the regular game mode. But we'll just stick for creative right now. Okay, so we have these sound files. Now down here, I've already made my sound changes and put my files right here. There's the file I used as my background sound. I'll just erase all of this stuff, hit the delete key like that. Get those out of there. And then let's redo that step, where I'll take one music file, convert that to the OGG format, and then save it several times for use in our game. Okay, I'll bring up the Audacity sound program now. It's one that I like to use for editing my sounds, mostly because it's free and it works just fine here for Minecraft. There it is, and I have a MP3 file in here called Lift Motif. I got this from the YouTube sound library. So we'll be using this as our new background sound file. Now you can get the Audacity program right here. It's at audacityteam.org. You have a download page, little button right down there. And it's here for Windows, Mac, or Linux. And again, it's a free download. Great little program for this kind of work. So here we are. All I need to do is just to convert this MP3 file into the .ogg format. So I'll go up to File, come down to Export, and then Export as OGG or OGG. Now it's going to export into the default Audacity folder up here. And then if you want to just navigate to where you want to place this file and then save it in that location, just go ahead and navigate. There's our new assets folder, and we're putting it into our sounds folder right here, inside of music, inside of game, and then inside of creative. Now I'll just save it right there and then choose OK. And there we go. There it is, saved in our proper folder. Okay, we're now done with Audacity. Just close that one down. There we go. Now all you need to do is just to save this over to the proper file name and then have the proper number of these. We need to have 6 files here inside of the creative folder. I'll be using the same sound file for all 6. There it is, creative 1 through creative 6. I'm just going to copy the name out right here. And let's just copy that. And then here, we need to change this name and then paste. There it is. There's our first file. Now all you need to do is just to duplicate this. You can have all six files. So just right click on this one and let's do a copy. There we go. And then right click and paste. And then just change this name here to number 2. There it is. And then do that 4 more times. And then we're all set to go. There we go. We now have all 6 of our needed music files here. And they're all in the right folder structure. Okay, that's all taken care of. Now all we need to do is to compile this together to make a new resource pack. So I'm just going to back up to my working folder right there. So we need that assets folder. This, of course, has that new sounds folder section. And then we need the pack MC Meta and the pack PNG. So I'll hold the control key down. Let's just grab both of those. Right click, and we're going to then archive these together into a zip file. Now, if you're using 7-Zip, which is right up here, you want to add to archive and then change that name. Let's just go in here. There's the name. Make sure that you're in the zip file format. That's very important right there, zip file format. And then it's changed the name. I'm going to call this one background music and 2 and choose OK. It will then zip this together and we're all set then to install that inside of the proper folder. Okay, just about done here, and then I'll switch over and I'll show you the same process here in WinRAR. There we go. There's that new zip file right there. Okay, same thing. Assets folder, pack.mcmeta and pack.png. Right click. If you're using WinRAR, you want to add to archive right there. Make sure you're in the zip file format. Very important. Has to be in the zip file format. And then simply give this the proper name and then choose OK to save it to that format. Now, I've already saved to the zip file format. It's right there, so we're all set to go. Okay, that's all great. We now have our new resource pack right here, which has our new background music. I can get rid of this thing up here, and I'll bring back up Minecraft. Okay, we're at the menu page now for Minecraft. When you're on this page, come down to Options right here. Click on Options, and then click on Resource Packs. There it is. Inside here, we need to put this new file here into our available resource packs over here. So click on Open Resource Pack Folder, and there's our new folder. Now all you need to do is to take this file that we just made, right-click and drag that over into the other folder. I'll copy like that. I always like copying so I can go back and I can change this in the future if I want to and not bother over here. So it's now inside of that folder, inside of Minecraft. Get those out of the way. When you have that done, click on Done. Click on Done again. Go back to Options. It's going to reload that resource pack folder, and you should now see the new file. There it is right there, music-2. Click on the arrow. Moves it over here inside of your selected resource packs. So that's all set to go. Then click on Done. It then reloads the Minecraft program with that new resource pack. Click on Done again. We now can launch into single player mode. I'm using my demo world up here. I'll go ahead and launch into that. And we'll now have our new background music, in this case, just in creative mode, but we now have that new file in there. Let's just turn around here. But there you go. That's how you can change the background music inside of Minecraft to whatever you want. Now, one thing just to keep in mind is that Minecraft is designed to have longer music files and kind of, you know, low-key things in the background. So if you have real short songs, they may cut out real fast and you have just, you know, empty, no music for a while until it kicks back in again. So make sure you have, you know, fairly long sound pieces for this and everything should be great. Okay, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to share and also don't forget to subscribe. I do a bunch of videos every single week and you can find out more about that on my channel. All right, and I'll see you next time.